of the streets and houses, rainbow climbing high. Everyone can see it smiling over the sky. Paint the whole world with a rainbow.
Hello, YouTubers. Welcome to Where's That Sausage Gone? This is my new rainbow build, the USS Potter Gold. Might as well have been called the USS Waste of Resources, but it is what it is. I'm going to do a quick run, then we'll go over the build, not in too much detail. There are better channels for that, Oggies, MC Stew, etc, etc. So let's get on with this, and we'll be back soon.
Got them to notice us. Let's go over and ask if their boss might come out of hiding. Keep concentrating fire on individual ships. Separate. We will not go quietly. Sensors are picking up small habitations in some of the atmosphere, possibly consistent with multiple temporary hideouts.
Okay, welcome back. Just quickly going to run over the build itself. We are in the Fleet Heavy Destroyer with an experimental upgrade on it. This is a lifetime sub ship, and in all honesty, I hadn't actually used it before this build. I just used it because it looks a little bit more like a cruiser than an escort, because I really can't stand the look of escorts using single beams. That's just a personal choice. Other things to mention, my main is an engineer, so the vast majority of the weapons are crit D damage and Crit D times 4. Really kind of only your attack should be using, your tactical should be using damage times 4. So let's crack on. Decent accuracy rating, crit chance and crit severity are okay. My endeavours are way behind, just simply because I don't have a huge amount of time to play the game. But when I do, I try and get them in when I can. Okay, it's rainbow build. So what I've tried to do is, wherever possible, have different energy types and different colours of energy in each slot. It's not been fully possible in this build. I found myself going down a rabbit hole and basically just stuck with it. Okay, so we'll run through it. The weapons up front, we have the isolated plasma beam array. This is a lockbox weapon. So yeah, obviously that involved spending some resources on getting the actual weapon. The inhibiting power on beam array, which is actually a rep weapon from the rep stores, so that was actually fairly cheap. Another lockbox weapon, diffusive tetron beam array, which actually surprised me how much damage this did when I passed with this on an ISA. Yeah, it was pretty good. The dark matter quantum torpedo from the disco rep, most useful torpedo that I've come across. We have the colony deflector, we've got the competitive innovated impulse engines, we've got the disco core and shield two piece. At the rear, we've got the kinetic cutting beam, we've got the House Martok omnidirectional disruptor beam. Mainly that's there because it's what I had and it's green, so it's a different colour. The bow anti-proton omni, this isn't grey and it's also not been re-rolled. I ran out of salvage and I really couldn't be bothered getting any more, so it is what it is. But we've got a yellow weapon, a purple weapon, a blue weapon, that's like an orangey red, the green disruptor, and the red anti-proton. The experimental weapon slot, I specifically wanted a ship that's going to have an experimental weapon shot slot, to basically slot this weapon. This is the thing you'll have seen with the multicolored spiral globules heading towards the ships. As a weapon, it's pretty rubbish, but it looks nice with the additional colours. Devices, these are basically what I have. So we've got the red matter capacitor, that's just the disabled systems back online, power levels, and we have the subspace field modulator, just to give some resistances and increased defense rating. For some reason, I've only got one energy amplifier on this ship. I thought it slotted more, but this is just bonus energy weapon damage. And as I don't have any deuterium surplus to hand, I've just basically stuck some shield batteries on there. The build itself, because I'm not focusing on any one specific energy type, the focus here has been on really increasing the crit chance and crit severity. So the Dominion Defense screen, good crit chance, good crit severity, and there's some regeneration and resistance boosts from the clicky. The bioneural infusion circuits, great critical severity on this one. Some increased capacity for the hull and some control expertise. The assimilated module, again, crit chance and severity, but mainly I've put this in here because it's giving me access to the two-piece set bonus with the cutting beam, which is a 2.5% chance to get the Omega weapon amplification, which is weapon power increased, drain resistance reduction, and minus 500 weapon power cost, which I'm not quite sure what that's supposed to mean, but there you go. We've got the tachyokinetic converter, again, crit chance severity, some control expertise, and the turn rate, which I don't really need in the ship, but it's nice to have. The Ultimid modified swarm processor, a good amount of crit chance on this one. Again, accuracy, don't particularly need it, but it's nice to have. I did toy with the idea of putting the Ultimate Omni on this, but because it's a bluey green when it fires, and I don't know, it didn't sit right with me. It's just me being anal about these things. We have the Domino, which it would normally give me a decent Cat 1 phaser damage boost, but there are no phasers on this this ship. That wasn't by design, that's just the way it ended up. It's really here for the clicky, which is obviously great for the firing cycle haste, because this is a beam overload build. All the haste we can get is really useful. 25% bonus all damage, which is fantastic. And then obviously we got some recharge boosts as well on there. The DPRM. I know people say this is the best console in the game, and I can't really argue with that, but I find that I can build effectively without it. I know my override subsystem safeties builds a lot of different kind of surgical strikes builds, I should say. I tend not to use it because I can get away without it. But there's no doubt in the 4% bonus damage, resistance rating, and whole regen are all really useful and great. The Locus custom fire controls, good amount of crit chance on this one, and obviously this is here for the two piece as well, which is giving me the 1% crit severity buff for 20 seconds, and it stacks up to 25 times. Because I'm not using any particular energy type, I've got to be careful with what I put in here for the tech consoles. So these are the spire locators, but they're just for the generic beams, they're not for specific weapon types. You do get less of the Cat 1 percentage bonus increase using these, but again, it's negligible, so I'm not majorly concerned about any of that. Skills, it's Intel Strategist. The actual slotted skills are what they are. I don't change them. They've been like this for a good while. Just simply can't be bothered. Traits, space traits, got adaptive offense, Terran targeting systems, inspirational leader, fragment of AI tech, context of the kings, superior beam training, operative, intelligence agent attaché, and innocuous. We've also got the Boimler effect in here. Now, what I've found is that this isn't giving me the cooldown fully that I need. So I'm actually running this with Photonic Officer 1, which seems to do the trick, and in a furnace that as a science slot there, I don't feel like I'm missing out on slotting anything else. Starship traits, we got emergency weapon cycle, overpowered and overgunned, preferential targeting, strike from shadows, super weapon ingenuity, and Terran goodbye. A lot of these are quite expensive to get, but I mean, if you, like I said, if you look at some of the other channels, Augie's, MC Stews certainly is really good for the kind of alternatives on the mid-range builds. Really, really informative, so check him out. And space rep, we've got tireless agility, precision, magnified firepower, enhanced rendering shots, and advanced targeting systems. Stations, okay, so tactical team 1, scatter volley 1, to obviously trigger the preferential targeting on the beam overlords. Torpedo spread 3, best serve goal 1, simply because I really couldn't think of anything else to just stick in there. I mean, I could have put Mr. Potato Head in, or an engineer for the emergency power to engine, something like that. Distributed targeting 1, just spread around some of the damage. Chemisite laced weaponry 2, just to work with the torchbed 3. The main damage dealer, which is beam overload 3. Attack pattern beta 3 for the debuff. Engineering team 1, just because, yeah, why not? Directed energy modulation, it's not massively useful because the cooldown is ridiculous, but there is some kind of shield and armor penetration which can come in handy. Emergency power to weapons 3, tractor beam 1, and photonic officer 1, which we've already talked about. The duty officers, active space, so we've got a couple of energy weapon officers with the stacking crit chance for the energy weapons. We've got one for the stacking crit severity, projectile weapons officer, recharge time on the torpedoes, con officer, recharge time for evasive manoeuvres, and Brad Boimler, because why not? It's just a area of effect on the torpedoes. You know, it doesn't do a huge amount of damage, but it's fine. I kind of wish I had these all purples, but it is what it is. In truth, I think we'd all love the all the Borg officers, but I'm not spending that kind of resource. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, click me a like, subscribe if you so wish, and until next time, farewell. Okay, thank you, bye.